occasion of World Population Day. World Population Day is celebrated on 11th of July every year to raise the awareness of population issues raising around the world. The tremendous growth in world population has led to scarcity of resources, but Indian culture, where children are taught to contribute to the resources, and this can only happen by the increased population, which is good for economic benefit in efficient and decent pattern. So, do you think it should be controlled? What will be the number of human beings in earth can sustain if not controlled? Are we getting close to that number? Well, on these issues, our debaters will determine the truth today. We all have gathered here to have a debate or discussion on the topic, growing population of India is boon, not a bane. I welcome our judges, Father Rector Joseph Thadmanal S.J., Sister Grace S.C.S.C. and Professor Dr. Niharika Kumari. Now, I would like to call the first speaker, Shivang of BCP 2B, who is going to speak in support of the motion.
Good morning to one and all present here. Reverend Father Principal, respected teachers, seniors and my dear friends. I, Shivang Singh of BCP 2B, is going for the motion on the topic increasing population is boon, not a bane. Some of the people says increasing population decreases the job opportunity. Some of them says increasing population leads poverty. Some of them says increasing population leads starvation. Why? A big why to this. It is only because of the lack of the information provided to the public. The government of India had launched many schemes for the public, such as pension for the widow women, and loans for the students, and a better education at cheap cost for the poor students. But we are not getting benefited of all these schemes because of the lack of the information provided by the public. So we don't have appropriate knowledge about all that scheme, so we are not getting benefited. It is collectively all about proper planning, proper organizing and proper staffing. Our India will not be developed, and then all the investor will invest their money in other country, means outside the country, because the Indian people will not be literate, because they won't get benefits. They won't get benefits of all that schemes because they don't have that much amount of money to study in private institutions. Decrease in dependency ratio will increase the saving. If the saving rise, investment increase, and rise in the investment boost productivity, thus prosperity. India's population termed as young population, and between 2020 to 2050, average age of Indian population will around 29 years, which is the productive age. Thus, it can help the economy to grow. Larger skilled population means a natural inclination of foreign companies to offer the young new projects. From economic point of view, there is a concept called demographic dividend, meaning over the years, countries with high population would have a large young populations to join the workforce, in contrast to other countries who might have trouble in replacing their existing workforce. Thank you.
Good morning, respected Father Principal, Father Rector, Father Vice Principal, my respected teachers and dear friends. I am Aishwarya from BA Second, and I am going to speak against the motion. So, I agree. India is a country of young people. The population is young. But what if the young population is unemployed? So, I left this question up to you. Will India withstand the growing necessities of the young population, or it will perish in the process of production and development. So, my first point is, China, we often compare ourselves to China, America. China is a country where population is very high, but it has channelized the population for something very better. They have used the population in a productive way. The maximum number of Chinese people are employed. They are not starving. The record says that India is a country where mass people are starving, they are uneducated, and they have not attained the 100% of literacy rate till now. We are in 71st year of independence and we are not fully literate. Wow. Humans are the greatest asset of any nation. Yes, the power of nation lies in its people. But what if the people are hungry, uneducated and not employed? So it could be as dreadful as the down. It could be dreadful and the only reason for the downfall of any nation. India's country with very high population, but the literacy, but the unemployment rate is not up to mark. So we need to work on that. We often criticize and accuse government for not providing adequate resources for our development. But what? Government has launched many campaigns for the stopping of population. But it depends on us, how we are using it. We should educate our population, we should educate our people to utilize and channelize their power, their energy towards a productive field, not towards something that is very dreadful. From economic perspective, I would like to say, India has the growing GDP in current scenario, but in comparison to other nations, we are still very back. So, I would like to conclude my speech with that. India is country of young people, but the population is not developing up to mark and it is baneful. Thank you.
Good morning to one and all present here, respected judges, teachers and all my dear friends. I am Rashmi from BCP2B and I am going to speak in favor of the topic. Much like the womb needs to be filled with a baby, the world should be allowed to be naturally filled with the people. Our population is an asset, as it means mixed talent, different mental setups, which will subsequently lead to progress, fame and money. If we look in the fact that China is number one in the terms of population, but they have utilized their population in a positive manner and it shows they top the chart in every possible sphere. We have the largest human resources. Their power can be efficiently utilized for the development, education and in providing jobs to all. Every official, planner, politician and the most who occupy the position of influence say population is a liability because they have failed to deliver on their promises and duties. If these people look into this as a resource and invest in terms of efforts, policy, financial allocations, partnership with industries and private agencies, our population can be turned into an amazing asset. One most important action to be initiated is to revamp our educational system into the HRD process to convert ordinary people into an extraordinary performer. India can do it and can be global power economically, politically, culturally, as well as in the knowledge arena. Now, think of an entrepreneur or a businessman planning to start a new business. Where do you think they will open a key branch or a head office? Of course, the answer will be the former city with large population because higher density of population provide both the potential market and the easier availability of workforce. The country or the state with a greater urbanization or a greater number of people will be far more competitive with the another country or the state with a few number of people. And that's the reason why states like Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, Maharashtra are economically better far off than their less urbanized cousins, Bihar, UP and Orissa. So we need more population if we want higher economic growth and spread the arc of prosperity. India's real problem is not a large population, but its inability to use. So it's time to stop bothering about the count of Indians and start devising a way to use them and take the economy to the great high. Because ultimately it's people that matter. Everything else can be mined, can be manufactured and grown on the ground. Thank you.
Good morning, respected judges, teachers and my dear friends. I, Gaurav Raj of BV, is here to present my view against the motion. People look at population as a huge opportunity for a nation to achieve its ambitions. There are many people also who look at it as a problem or have a negative perspective about it. I accept that huge population provides us with a great manpower. But with the increasing population, there is a lack of resources too. With the increasing population, from where we will increase our resources? As the population has increased, resources have completely decreased. There has been a degradation of environment too. The study for CO2 for fuel combustion has been said that there is a from 181 million tons, it has increased to 2066 million ton fuel combustion in India, which is about 46% account of India in whole Asia. Can you imagine? We are part of 46% for CO2 in the whole Asia. Another problem is that employment. From where we will generate the employment? About 50% of the Indians are unemployed, and in which 45% are below the age of 25, which are totally dependent on their parents or have some, they can't do the job because it is not our culture that the students who are studying that they can do the extra jobs with their studies. They are completely dependent on their parents. So they are not, they can't add to the national income. There is a problem of investment too. Our growth is going at the rate of 1.8%, and the total capital output is about 4:1 in the ratio. And therefore, there must be a capital invest. There must be a national investment of 7.2%, which is not done. Population can be the strength only when we have the power to feed our nation, provide healthy food to them, and to provide basic facilities to them. Then they can only mold into an asset. Otherwise, our population is always a liability for us. And better, it is always seen that an unhealthy, unnutritious, unnourished and uneducated nation is always below the small but healthy, educated, completely established and employed nation. Thank you.
Good morning, worthy opponents, judges and all my dear friends present in this august house. I, Muhammad Mudabbar Kamar of PCFS, stand before you all keeping my words on the topic, population of India is a boon, not a bane. I am for the motion. Human beings are the resource, God-gifted resource to a country, just like air and water. Are we limiting air and water? No. Then why to limit human beings? Just because we people are unable to manage this resource, we cannot reject them. India's population is termed as a young population. By 2020 to 2050, the average age of India would be 29 years, with China 37 years and Japan 48 years. With such young talents in your country, it will provide you technologies, innovations and skills, which will surely enrich the resource of the country. People say, huge population becomes a barrier in the development of the country. If such is the case, what about China? It is the most populated country and still far more developed. People say, population becomes a cause for unemployment. I say, it becomes a cause for employment. The need is to make people educated, skilled, and provide them with opportunities. Be sure that not every individual is a job seeker. There could be job creators. If we work towards creating more job creators, surely we will be able to give jobs not only to people of India, rather people all over the globe. India is the largest provider of skilled manpower. By educating these manpowers, we can provide them to various fields, which will lead India towards prosperity. Growing population provides a country demographic dividend, and it also helps maintaining the demographic dividend. Large-scale population shows natural inclination of foreign countries with new ideas and projects, and yes, we can do them cost-effectively. A country's power lies in the hand of citizens. India's rising power marks India's growing power. India's rising population marks India's rising power. Technologies, innovations, skills alone cannot take a country to the front rank. All they need behind them is the human beings, the manpower behind them. At last, I would like to say, in every field, from education to sports, from war to peace, from success to development, from innovation to technology, we need human beings. If such important human beings are, why to reject them if God is gifting this resource to your country? So instead of rejecting them, we should accept them with our arms open. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone, President. Honored management, welcome chief guest and guests of honor. All the dessert invitees and reverend teacher and of course our starring friends. We are here with a serious topic, India's population is a boon or a bane. So since I'm speaking against the motion, so India's population is a bane due to increasing population growth. Now India's population is similar to a virus. As virus damages the computer system whole, same India's population also damages the whole system, whole working mechanism of India. Now we will come to the point that why it happens. There are many reasons which support my point. The first reason that global warming increases due to population explosion. How deforestation takes place after population increasing, deforestation takes place and what will happen? All the trees are cut. And then we need more oxygen and we will not get appropriate oxygen. We will have the deficiency of oxygen, we will get more carbon dioxide. That will lead to global warming. Now corruption is the biggest problem which is increased by the increasing of population. How? We can say if population will increase in this way, what is the increasing way? We can see 1.2% is the growth rate of our India. If we talk about China, China has 0.5% growth rate. If we talk about America, America has 1.2% growth rate. And now if we talk about Bangladesh, 1.9 is the growth rate. Now we are coming to the point that 29 crore peoples in India are illiterate till now, which is more than the Indonesia's population. We can't even think. 19 crore people are sleeping without eating. We can't even think. 22% people are below the poverty line. 10.7% are under unemployment. Now what we are looking for, if population explosion will be in this way, then definitely it will be a curse for our India. Population explosion is a communicable disease which can be seen throughout the world and the country. What we are looking at, two perspectives I will give you. The first is if we take the example of China. We are saying that China is increasing, China is developing. So why don't you think that why China has banned our regulation? Why China has made a rule that our population is not necessary? Why they have made a rule that only a family should have only one child, not more than one? Thank you.
Good morning to one and all present here. I, Apurva of BCA Part 2, is present here to express my opinions on the topic, the growing population of India is a boon and not a bane, and I am here to speak for the motion. The current population of India is 1.34 billion, and figure shows that 50% of India's population is below the age of 25 years and 65% is below the age of 35 years. So we can say that India's population consists mostly of the youth. In our country, there are a lot of startups today. In the future, these startups would help in the development of the nation. From the economic point of view, there is a concept called demographic dividend, meaning over the years, India would have a large young population to join the workforce, whereas other countries would have a trouble in replacing their workforce, which is getting old. A country's development lies in the power of its citizens. And India's growing population could be a proof for India's rising power. Large number of populations means more consumers, more workers to work in a factory, and more soldiers to fight a war on the border. It is just the way how the country will manage its population. The best example is China, how it has proved its growing population as a boon for its country. Population growth also provides us with people of multiple talent in the field of sports, arts, and music. If a country invests well on human resources and provides the people enough opportunities, the country can come up with a vast pool of talent. If the number of working population is greater than kids and elders, they can support them. This will reduce the dependency rate. As the rate decreases, the investment, the savings will increase, and so will the investment. Whenever we talk about population growth, one question arises, that what the government can really do to stop this population growth? From spreading awareness in the masses, nothing else. Being a democratic nation, it also cannot forcefully impose one child law. So we should stop discounting the number of Indians and start devising ways so that it could help for the development of the country. Because if we cannot change the situation, then at least we can make the situation better. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Respected judges, faculty members, fathers, and my dear friends. As introduced by Purva, I am Ankit of PCP2, speaking against the motion. India is 7th largest country on earth, having 2.4% of land, whereas 17.74% of total world's population. Just by thinking about the demographic and geographic profiles of India, anyone can say India is very highly populated. Generating employment for this such a high population is a very difficult task. Illiteracy is increasing day by day, and unemployment is showing an increasing trend. We studied in economics that resources are limited, but our demands are not. It's truly said. As rise in population is causing inflation rate to grow and over-exploitation of resources. We also studied that when resources are been abundant, its cost falls. Therefore, the cost of labor in India is very less. It makes labor to work hard to achieve less. Overpopulation is also responsible for poverty. It encourages people to get into a vicious circle of illiteracy, unemployment, and finally to poverty. 2.4% of land and 17.74% of total world's population. A very high pressure on limited infrastructure we have, and to increase the infrastructure, we would harm the ecosystem, because wildlife and forest life would be harmed. Population explosion leads to migration. Migration in sense people from rural areas move to urban areas in search of quality life. But when they move, they stay in slums. These slums are most unhygienic and most insanitary place. Unemployment and poverty leads to frustration and anger among the youth, causing robbery, prostitution, murders, etc. Terrorism, we see every part of the country. Why is this? It is because of the anger in the educated, unemployed youth. Overpopulation also leads to conflicts among the people. Conflicts over water, we hear about it every now and then. Taking just an example, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, they filed suit against one another in Supreme Court. And the reason for the conflict is water of River Ganges. Being a commerce student, I would like to say that persons are means as well as ends of economic development. If we have them in adequate amount, it would prove to be an asset for our country, but if it is in abundant, it would be a liability. Population has crossed the optimum limit in India and has become a liability. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone present here. So, I'm going to speak for the motion on the topic, growing population of India is a boon, not a bane. Let's start with an instance. We're talking about the big picture here. Take the big picture down 10 years down the line, right? Any big businesses, big entrepreneurs and business tycoons start with ashes. They don't have a proper business models prepared right then. They start with ashes, very basic. and they take it to another level and create a hell lot of business impact there. Let's start with the co-founder of Infosys, Mr. N.R. Narayan Mundry. He belonged to a very poor background. He struggled his way up and then he struggled and then he created something which was unimaginable, which was something great, which you cannot create in one day. It requires sweat, determination and a lot of things which we... What I am focusing on right now is that it's in your hand. What do you want to do? We talk about poverty, we talk about overpopulating the nation. Why not we utilize all the resources, all the human resources that we have? We are focusing on the problem. If we focus on the problem, then there's a way out. That is the thing. Let's start with the mainstream idea of youth. As we know that the population of the India is mostly contributed by the youth. The age group of 25 to 30 years, that is the greatest population of India that youth is the mainstream of which it, youth is an age where we are most productive and we are a valuable asset to the company. The GDP rates, the inflation rates goes down. I've prepared a data which shows that the GDP keeps on increasing from 5.46% to 8.08% from 2012 to 2021. The inflation rates are decreasing. This is clearly an indication that we are leading to a better future here. We are leading to a nation which we can, from a developing nation, it's not very far. The day when the developing nation becomes a developed one. Thank you.
In the words of Helen and I quote, "Once it was necessary that people should multiply and be fruitful if the race was to survive. But now to preserve the race, it is necessary that people hold back the power of propagation." Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, respected judges and my dear friends. Today, I, Milan, stand in front of you to speak on the topic, India's population is a boom, not a bane. And I am strictly against this mission. Before going further, I would like to take a brief introduction about World Population Day. World Population Day is an international level campaign awareness program being celebrated all through the world on 11th of July. It is celebrated to increase the awareness of people towards the increasing population worldwide. It was first started in 1989 by the United Nations of Development Program. Every year, this UNDP set up the theme, and now the theme of 2018 is Family Planning is a Human Right. Now let's talk about India. The current population of India is 1.35 billion, as based on the recent United Nations estimate. India's population is equivalent to 70.74% of total world population. It is just behind China, which has the population of 1.37 billion. It becomes increasingly difficult to provide basic facilities if population is huge or increasing at an alarming rate. There are not enough resources to feed such a huge population. This also leads to problem of nutrition, as insufficient nutrition leads to widespread of issues of malnutrition. The 2017 Global Human Index report ranked India 100 out of 118 countries with a serious hunger situation. Among South Asian nations, India ranked third behind Afghanistan and Pakistan with a score of 29.0, which is a serious situation. Sanitation and health is compromised, as providing health care to such a huge number of people is difficult. Now, everybody is talking about population. Population increase or development, population provide this and population provide that. But I would like to mention here, you sir, that the population does not give you development, but a developed population will give you development. So instead of focusing on that we should increase our population, let's increase on the focus that how to develop our population. I'm not against that we should stop our population. I'm saying that just take care of the population in some condition. Let's not make it. At last, I would like to conclude here that if we do not heart our population with justice and compassion, I would like to repeat this. If we do not heart our population with justice and compassion, the nature is going to do so for us. And trust me, ma'am, when the nature is going to do so, it will be true. Thank you.
Good morning, one and all present over here. Respected father, sister, professors, and my dear fellow mates, I, Prerna, of BBA second year, stand in front of you to represent my views on the given topic, population is a boon, not a bane. There is a speaking which says, we can control the birth of other species, but we cannot control our own. This is very true. India holds the rank of second position in the total ranking of world population. Is it worthful? If it is worthful, then why the government of India keep on initiating these schemes like Hum Do Hamare Do, single child plan? There ample amount of negativity follows, which creates by the population. First is pressure on land. Over the last 4 decades, since 1971 to 2001, there is a large amount of increasing population. In the year 1971, the total number of population were 108.6 million, and in the end of 2001, it increased with the number of 180.06 million. There are a large amount of labor force engaged in the agriculture field, which leads to the decrease in the holding of land by 0.23 hectares, despite increasing operational holdings. There are also many negativity, which is number of unproductive consumers are keep on increasing day by day. India is a country where the unproductive consumers are increasing. Unproductive consumer means those consumers which do consume but are not employed. And they include children below the age of 15 years and adults above the age of 60 plus. According to the data of 9th 5th year plan, it is mentioned that in the year 2016, the data of 60 plus above the data of the old year 60 plus was 63.2 million, and at the end of 2016, it increased by 112.6 million, and the data of children increased by 350.6 million. We also face a lot of unemployment. According to when the first 5th year plan was initiated, the total number of unemployed persons were 3.3 million. But at the end of the planning, it increased by 5.3%. By the end of second 5th year plan, it increased by 7.1 million. By the end of third 5th year plan, it increased by 9.1 million. And by the end of fourth 5th year plan, it increased by 9.1 million. And by the end of 8th fifth year plan, the total amount of unemployed person in all the three categories is 65 million. We are increasing day by day, but we are not controlling, we are not using our... Thank you.
Thank you, Prerna. As the first round is completed, there will be the second round, which is rebuttal round. I once again would like to let you know the rules and regulations of rebuttal round. In rebuttal round, every student will get maximum 1 minute to argue or support his or her arguments. Maximum 2 questions can be asked. No cross-questioning is allowed.
I ask, according to a report by Indian Express, the Association of Mizoram, Young Mizo Association, has urged their people to have more child because their land has been occupied by the migrants of other countries. And he also added that we cannot move ahead with our population, higher population. So where is the land going? We have sufficient amount of land. India is still green and we cannot have any such problems like global warming and any other problem like due to a population. Secondly, I would like to ask, if it is our fault that we people are unable to manage the resource, manage the population, so we cannot blame any other thing that population is causing any other problems. Secondly, if many people say it causes unemployment, I say if there are 500 people unemployed, and in that 500, if only one are a job creators, the it can provide jobs to rest 499 people. Thank you.
So, you mean to say that there should be no stoppers on increasing population? So just remind once again, I will remind you that the China's, we are talking about China and we are taking references from China's. Don't you think we are abiding more than chewing? We can see the statistics of China. China has more land. We have only 2.4% land. And China has 9.737%. So China has that resources. So they have developed. Or again, if you will talk that why don't we have resources? So just take an example of Bangladesh. Bangladesh is in the annoying position because of the increasing population. His population rate is increasing annually 1.9%, whereas our 1.2% and for China 0.5%. Now, if we talk about India, only 81% farmers have less than 2 hectare land holdings. Now, we come to the point of unemployment, and he said group demographic dividend. So, what is demographic dividend we will talk about. So we will see demographic dividend work same as in the Bangladesh. Bangladesh has also their demographic dividend. Thank you.
You are saying that there will be no any effect on the global warming. How you can say that there will be no effect on the global warming when whole world carbon emission was about 0%, but then India grew with the 5.2% in the carbon emission. There is always a problem with the climate. There is no rain. We have no sufficient water in Delhi. There is day by day problem. Water problems are coming in Delhi, Mumbai, or all metro cities. There is always a water problem. Another problem is rising because of population only. That we don't have sufficient job opportunities for the people are educated. They have the proper qualification, but they are not getting jobs because our per capita income is also decreasing day by day.
Respected fathers, my judges, the staff, and all my dear students. At the outset, I'd like to congratulate the organizers of this program, this debate. So, Dr. Khalid and companions who organized this debate. Last year, when we had the debate, it's a major change that has taken place this year. It was only one girl, and this year we have 5 of them. So women's empowerment has taken place. So congratulations, girls who have taken part in this. And I want to congratulate the participants. It is not easy to come on stage and speak to the audience here, and they have taken this opportunity well, and they made a good presentation in general, and I was really happy that they have been able to speak here without the help of a paper, except one or two who more or less read it out. That's not too good, but others were able to speak on their feet, and that certainly is very good. And the language in general was good. You've been able to communicate well. There are some mistakes here and there. And the data that you gave is certainly very good. Some gave very good data, information about the situation of the population, work and so on. And that was very good. And then using this lectern here, there is a problem because you cannot use your gestures. You are holding on to the lectern here, so that controls your ability to communicate much more freely. that is a problem. A couple of things that might help you, certainly, as you continue this particular ability to develop this ability to speak in public. I think it's not only for these students here, all of you sitting there, ask yourself, if you are standing here, how will you perform? I think both those who spoke in favor of the proposition and those who spoke against had good arguments. A couple of things that I would like to make, remarks I would like to make to improve the situation. One is, you should be aware of the important people in the hall. So you should address certainly the dignitaries, the judges and others who are present here. That is something that you should make sure that you have it before you come here. Have a look at the audience and see who are all sitting here. Number one is that. I think most of you did that, but I think a few of you mentioned, forgot that. Secondly, the data. Of course, we cannot go and check the data that they present here, and hopefully they have it. They've had enough data. There are two things that are important in the presentation. One is the content. What are you saying? Do you have enough material? Are you deep enough, or just superficial statements are being made? Or you have material that are relevant, meaningful, and really proving a point that you are making here. Therefore, you have to worry about the content material you collect before you come for a debate. Second one is the presentation. Definitely language is an issue. English was in general good. I must congratulate the participants. However, there are problems of accent. Every word in English is accented, unfortunately, and our languages don't have this terrible thing called accent in our language. And every word has a pronunciation of its own. There are no common rules of pronunciation. Therefore, we have to know more or less every word in English, and therefore there is a problem. And therefore, there have been accent problems, some pronunciation problems. There are not too many, but there are a few. It affects your presentation, especially when you want to come to the higher level of presentation. Definitely these are counted. The judges certainly will take into account when they judge this. And finally, I would like to say this, that all of us should come onto the stage at least sometime before you leave this college. Whatever the situation, not necessarily for debate. Certainly you should learn to express yourself, no matter in a play, in a debate, in a skit, or whatever. You must appear on the stage. Don't leave this college without appearing at least once on the stage. That would be a great pity. If you spend 3 years here, never have the joy of coming here and looking at the audience and giving the audience a chance to look at you. So certainly you must make this, take these opportunities in the college. Once again, thank you very much, and all the participants and the audience here for this presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Father. Now may I call Professor B.N. Chaudhary to address the gallery.
Good morning. This was not on the schedule, but the topic was so live, and because most of us belong to that topic, I could not resist speaking a few words with you. The first thing, this topic must be discussed by the youth of today. Government may plan, you will be executing the population policy. The execution is in your hands. So whether India will grow, the economy, the population of India will grow at a rapid rate, in a controlled manner, the quality of population, the quantity of population, the structure of the population, this all will be decided by you, executed by you. So you are actually the torchbearers of the government policy. So be prepared for that. Secondly, well, there are two sides of it. All the theories of population say that we should have an optimum amount of population. Less than that, we do not develop well. More than that, we overuse the resources. But the problem is, how do you determine what is the optimum population? There is conflict. Because the optimum size of the population will be determined by the economic model that you implement. Whether you are going for labor intensive technology or capital intensive technology, the size of population will vary. Whether you are going for one type of model or the another type of model, the size of population will vary. Secondly, we have a habit of blaming population for everything. And we do not take the blame ourselves. Have we not ignored the population all through? See this. Take the example of India. Since 1947, since we got independence, our GDP increased at least 100 times. And what is the rate of growth of population? We were around 40 crore at the time of independence, and we are around 130 crore today. So what? Not more than 3 or 3.5? So 10 times or much more than that, we increased our output, our resources, and we grew only by 3.5 times, and yet we have been having a huge number of illiterate population, uneducated population, unskilled population, underdeveloped population. On the other hand, we have been having 1 trillionaire now. Trillionaire is a very small thing now. So we are having new trillionaire every year. Almost 74%, households of India control 54% of the resources. Keval 76 parivar ke paas India ka 54% resource controlled hai. Is it the problem of population or is it the problem of injustice? Injustice that we do to our population. We have the habit of saying that dull people, unemployed people, uneducated people, burden. Remember, that burden creates wealth for every billionaire. We have city, we have big slums. The city produces less. The slum is the biggest producer. In each factory, in each column, on each construction site, each road, each dam, everything that you produce, that slum dweller is the biggest producer of the world. Wherever you have the shining big cities, you have big slums. And you say, these are the dirty people. They are the cause of problem. They are the boon for the big and mighty. So manage your population. Manage your development model. Obviously, once you grow, you know that your family size should not be much bigger. None of you will be willing to have more than 2 children. So you know it. Right? Those who don't know are the underdeveloped ones. Take care of them. Give them the right education. Give them the right way of living. Give them employment. Give them the opportunity. They will also come and preach, you should not have more than 2 children. Right? So, stop blaming population. Take care of your population. And the population will become your asset. The population will become the source of your development. The population will lead you to all sorts of development. The development of civilization is the development of people. The development of civilization does not mean big buildings, big roads, transportation, big everything. It is meant for the people, and we have the habit of cursing our people. Stop doing that. Okay. Get a balance of it. take a good care of population, that is the only thing that you can do. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to call Kirti for vote of thanks. Be thankful for what you have. You will end up having more. If you concentrate on what you have, you will never ever have enough. Good morning, everyone. I, Kriti Kishan from BCP 2nd A, feel honored and privileged to propose a vote of thanks. First of all, I would like to thank the management, Father Rector, Father Principal and Father Vice Principal for giving us an opportunity to conduct such an enlightening debate on World Population Day. I would like to extend my sincere gratitude to judges, Father Rector, Sister Grace, Nihalika Ma'am for taking out time from their busy schedule and encouraging all the debaters. I sincerely thank all the professionals, staff, administrative and maintenance department for their timely help and making the necessary arrangements. Last but not the least, I'd like to thank all the students for being patient audience. Thank you.